Hey guys, and welcome back to Board Game Night, and welcome back to Risk Legacy with Lolash, NG Paradox, Rhapsody, and Salty Potatoes.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey.
I actually thought I was going to get a silent treatment there.
Oh dear. So we're on NG's turn, and so NG, you got to stop Taddy's getting that continent bonus, because Rhapsody can't. You gotta stop him. You can't give him 5 free troops. He'll win the game.
I don't know. I might want him to finish the game.
I don't know. I feel like Potato's got this anyway.
I'll be honest, right? This is not just me being like disingenuous. I don't see how I've got this. Could somebody explain to me how I could win?
Yeah.
If
okay,
please don't tell him.
No.
Please, like, genuinely tell me how I could win if I can. I want to know.
A big dollar.
He's bluffing. He knows how he can win. He's been staring at his game board for the last week.
Oh my god. Wow. You know what? You guys have a high opinion of me. I like that. A much higher opinion of me than I have of myself. So that is remarkable. But seriously, how can I win?
It's better to overestimate your enemies than underestimate them.
Absolutely.
Wisely said, Sun Tzu.
Taddies, you're going to get 7 troops next turn, unless somebody takes a province off you.
How will I get 7?
You'll get 8, like... thank you.
Oh, eight. I got 8, sorry, actually. Yes, okay. Yeah. Yes, okay.
Yep. I think you'll find I'll get 8.
I'm just going to attack Iceland. Let's get this going. Let's get my turn over and done when we get to the real turns.
3v1.
The real turns.
Hey,
I got
5.
Called
out. 6. Ooh. Yes, I get a victory card. That's all I really wanted.
I don't know why you're fucking with me. Like,
I got called out for doing something similar to what you just done there, Tati. And they're like, oh my god, you rolled a 1 and then re-rolled it into a 6.
No,
I just took Iceland. Iceland's worth 2.
It's very, very clear, like, what a roll is. Like, that is a roll, whereas just, like, fiddling with the dice is not a roll. Like, it's difficult for me and Stegio, because we're, like, at the other side of the world, and the game is being hosted in Australia, so it's very, very difficult for us, I would say.
Okay, guys, I just took the Iceland card. That's worth 2 stars.
Yeah,
so that's quite nice.
It certainly is.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, did you hear about the cards? Did you hear about the court case between Iceland and Iceland? Iceland, the country, is suing Iceland, the supermarket, for the use of their intellectual property. Nice. Which is complete bullshit. I mean, like, Iceland, the supermarket's been around for 43 years, and I was looking on Twitter, and all the little Twitter lawyers were like, yeah, but I mean, Iceland, the country, was founded in 1839, and it's like, yeah, but who gives a fuck? If you don't protect your property, then it gets fucking used, and you can't protect it.
Did intellectual property law even exist back in the 1800s? Like, fucking, who knows?
I guess it's Rhapsody's turn.
Oh, you resolved by sitting on Iceland.
Yeah,
I went to Iceland, I took the Iceland card, got 2 resource cards. And,
you got some frozen chicken, some bird's eye mashed potatoes.
That makes my life a little more difficult. Thank you for that. I was hoping to push through Iceland. All right. Right. Well, so I figure if I'm going to win, I'm going to have to win this turn.
Yeah.
So, absolutely. Yeah. I have a few options, which is take my 3 units, put them down on Venezuela, and try and push through Brazil, North Africa, East Africa. Which would mean 3 units. I'd have to win every roll.
Yes.
To account for the units I have to leave behind.
Yes.
Alternatively, I have the option to cash in my 5 coins in hand, because one of mine is a location worth 2 coins, get 10 troops plus my 3,
ooh,
and try and go on the warpath down to Western Australia.
I mean, you could go like Argentina and East Africa.
Yeah, why don't you just go to Argentina to East Africa? Either that, or just get 3 troops on Peru, cash your cards, and attack Argentina. Like,
The terrifying factor there for me is that there's bunkers on both Brazil and Argentina, so I think I lose units the majority of the time.
Just cash the troops then. Just go Peru, Argentina, Brazil, North Africa, East Africa. Easy 2 capital.
Easy money.
Easy money.
See,
like,
it's
I think
annoying, because I've been... I've been looking at this map for like a half week now, going, okay, how do I win in the next turn? And it never concerned me that I would do that one.
Why not? It's so, like, that's, you've got so many troops.
Because I'm dumb. Because I'm really stupid. I'll take
10 minutes. At least you're honest.
All right, so you're going to push for...
I have this image now of, like, when we all left last week, Rapsy just stayed here looking at the board.
Yeah, just I tried to, but it disconnected me from the server because I'm not hosting it. I love that I have fucking, like, speeder bikes, my goddamn. Like, NASCAR bikes, mine.
No, excuse me, NASCAR?
F1 cars.
Formula NASCAR. 1, sorry.
F1 cars, man.
You got a big fat NASCAR. DNF for that one, bitch.
Jesus. I don't think you should be allowed to attack this turn after that.
Dude, I don't even know what sports is. Don't judge me.
Do you even sports ball, bro?
So you got what, 13?
I sports balled once. I got most participatory. So that's good.
Is NASCAR even a sport? Like,
let's not get into that argument.
People say it is, though.
I mean, I could say the F1's a sport, but NASCAR, like, they barely even turn the fucking steering wheel.
That's 12, so 13. Oh, wow. 3 base and then 10, right?
What that's percentage correct. Of your viewer base is Australia? Not Australian. American, CJ?
American.
Pretty
yes.
sure. You just alienated, like, all of them.
Half of them.
Oh, sorry, I'm sure they're used to my NASCAR jokes by now. I make them, like, every other episode.
Okay. I declare attack on Argentina.
You declare nothing. All right. You activated my trap card.
Yeah, yeah. 3, 2, 1. Roll. That's a terrible roll.
Well, you got one of them. One each.
No. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait. No.
Okay,
no.
All right. 3, 2, 1. Roll. Wow.
What does the bunker do?
5, 1, 3. You push. So you defend.
Yeah, that's 1 each.
Okay. Wait, and really? Yeah, so I've lost 2 troops.
I thought.
Take them away. I'm pretty sure that Rhapsody. Yeah, it's the higher one. So Rhapsody won, beat 2 troops on that first engagement, not just 1 each.
Yeah.
Oh right, yeah. On the second engagement, because it's 5 and 3 versus 2 and 2. Yeah, you're right. You got me through. Yep.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. Oh.
You're in.
And then this
just
will
be the win and move.
I mean, I don't think.
Yep.
I don't think there's a single. I don't think it's even possible to lose from here. Like, unless the rolls are horrendous.
I'm trying my best to lose. I'll push into Brazil. So.
Steve,
Joe, sorry, Lolish defend. Whee! All time. It's a 5 and a 3.
4 and a 3 becomes a 5 and a 3. I win.
Yeah, I guess.
Wow.
These two.
This is spicy.
Alright.
Lolish, you're stunned an air jet engine.
3, 2, 1, go! 6, 5. I win both.
Oh, dude.
Jet engines can't melt a bunker, apparently.
All right,
the Lash
3,
is the jet
2, 1, roll!
Go! 6-4, so I win both.
Oh my god!
Yeah, wow. this is the kind of thing that would happen to me. All right, 3 again, roll!
3, 2, 1, go!
You need the...
6-4, yeah, I win both.
You need the X-Wing.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm dead.
Well, Orbital, what did you say like a second ago?
Anymore, right?
Wow, that's actually kind of horrific.
So you could push through.
If I succeeded, this is the last time I can even attempt to, and I'd have to win every roll from now on. So,
yeah.
All right, let's go. 5, 4, 3.
Go. 6-3.
Yeah, I fail. It's a 6.
I got you both.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's the kind of thing that would happen to me. Lose, how many units did I lose on that?
Wow.
10 units against 2. That makes
wow.
sense.
Wow.
I don't know, man. Potato still needs to do that Brazil-Argentina push, though.
Wow.
Yay, bunkers.
I don't think I can't win. I can't. I don't think I can. Fuck. Wow. That's actually kind of... Wow.
Well, I did conquer one thing, so don't I get a card?
You do get a resource card, because you did capture a location. That's very true.
Can I
You can only take Eastern. You can only take Eastern.
United States.
Yeah, you have to take Eastern US. Which you'd want to anyway, because...
Mm-hmm.
All right. So that's going to be the end of your turn, Rhapsody. Let's move on to Taddy's.
Well, I don't think I can. Like, if Rhapsody didn't manage to do that, then I don't think I can. I'll be honest.
Yeah, you can.
You think you've got worse rolls than that?
Yeah, well, maybe. I tried once before. I went for the GG push once before and it failed, didn't it?
Start in Egypt. Don't push through. Oh, right. No, you can't, because obviously you've got a lot of troops in Russia.
Yeah,
you're going to have to go through Middle East.
Yeah, you're going to have to go through Middle East. Oh, okay. All right.
3v1, Stejo.
6.
Oh, yep, you got him.
Oh, Jimmy.
All right, come on, Tom. Tom holds East Africa right
can
now.
Can I just express my disbelief, total disbelief, that Rhapsody did not win there? Like, I am utterly shocked.
Mental.
I'm utterly shocked.
He said he can't lose here, and he did.
Utter shock.
Mm-hmm. That's the problem. Someone cursed me by saying that it was impossible for me to lose, and then the die were like, I'll fucking show you.
I was hoping I could hold off at least a couple of these trips, man, but this is it.
Why? Like, I think that if somebody doesn't win here, then the board state is so fucked that I kind of want the game to be over.
Mate, Brazil is going to hold. Brazil is going to hold, I'm telling you.
Please,
right
God,
now.
No.
You're not taking Brazil. No one could.
5?
Fuck's
sake. Perfect. Perfect.
That's okay. Like, every place that Potato has taken has been by one.
All right, here we go. Come
just
on, baby.
Give me 2.
That's 6-5.
1-8.
That's a double 1-8. Kill.
Oh my god, the fucking
bunker.
I like how the bunkers are actually doing stuff for once.
Yeah, it's great. I'm loving it. All right, come on, Taddy. Bring it on.
Just be a never stop.
Just roll badly fucking once, please, dear god.
3-2-1, go. 6-5. I got you
both.
Oh
my god.
Double kill.
Wow. Are we going to see a double? This is crazy.
Ready, 3-2-1, let's do it.
These two guys, man.
That's 5-2, you got
double.
Both of those ones.
Thank God, thank
So it's 2v,
fuck.
It's 2v2 in a bunker though.
It is
Dude,
2v2
just take
in a bunker.
My life from me. Cut my life into pieces. I'm fucking done.
This is All my
right,
last resort.
Roll. 3-2-1. There we go, I gifted it to you, both dead.
Oh, there we go, Taddies.
That's not both dead.
That's one each.
What? One each.
One each because there's a bunker.
Three. Oh, right, because the three is... Yeah.
Oh my god. One fucking one roll.
Let me count.
Oh.
One roll.
I think mine's just frozen.
Oh my god.
G fucking G.
Things moving.
This fucking game.
I'll be back in a second.
Yeah, just reconnect, Paradox.
Oh my god.
That's metal.
Wow. That's actually...
Okay, so does that mean...
I want this game to be over. I don't care who wins. Like, oh god. Mm-hmm.
So I didn't even get my troops out for this. So
I get
3 troops, an extra one on Western Australia. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Bastard, just short.
Just short. I think NG did that to you last turn as well. And then Taddy's just did it to you then.
Mm-hmm.
Shutting you down.
I do.
I'll wait until. Alright, is Paradox back?
Yeah, I'm back. Just waiting
well,
for the
Stejo could win right here.
I doubt. Yeah. I don't...
Russia, Middle East, East Africa.
Yeah, I don't have
that's a good
troops,
point.
But,
like, every... That's a good point.
It feels like every turn someone can win.
Yeah,
I can get
he
a.
He can't lose!
I'm taking Great Britain, by the way. Just FYI, folks.
Yep.
Yeah, sure, man.
Nah, this is like last ditch attempt, really.
Dude, Rhapsody's was a last ditch attempt. Mine was a last ditch attempt. This is a last ditch attempt. It's just like somebody's just got to win. Like, please.
Yeah.
There's no order in the board. It's just
my dice have been shit anyway, so it's
tits
like...
up.
Are you kidding me? It's frozen again.
Oh my god, it's Paradox.
I joined and nothing's moving. Your men are just in the air.
Let's roll.
How?
Yeah, well done.
Olash, I don't like your internet.
It's not my internet. I'm connecting to guys on the other side of the world. You're nice and close.
Down in the Middle East.
Six.
Five, I gotcha. Six.
I roll a six and a five. He rolls a six.
Mm-hmm.
Trust me,
just need to
dude.
Hold out just a little
I know.
Bit
I know what you mean. No, I want Steejo to win. I you know, me. I want someone to win. Please, dear God.
No, yes. No. It's a 2v1. It's a 2v1 to win the game.
It's not a 1v1 though. It's never going to be the 1v1 situation that it was in Argentina. Well, it might okay. be actually.
Well, maybe.
How about the 12v2?
Yeah, gotta beat a 4.
No.
Wow.
No, Steejo
wow.
wins.
No.
Steejo wins.
Steejo wins.
No. Wait, no. Steejo what?
Wins. I rolled a 1-2.
What? Phil. He rolled a 1-2.
What?
It's a 1v1. Right.
It's a 1v1.
Let's do it.
Oh, I saw the 4. Sorry, my bad. I
oh my god.
Oh my
hey.
God.
He got him. I won. Finally. Oh, oh, one trip. Oh, amen. Oh, fucking GG.
Oh my god.
I honestly did not expect to win that in a million.
Oh my god.
Years.
Holy shit.
Do you know what's sad? If I was thinking, if it got to me, I actually could have won, because I would have got 10 men next turn.
Lol.
Nah.
I could have gone to Russia down to East Africa.
It was just horrifically wow. unlucky that Raps didn't win. Like, it honestly should have been Raps.
Oh, that was
there.
Metal.
And it just
Steejo,
didn't. Like,
have
that
you
was
ever
nuts.
Heard of the? Have you ever heard of the Australian skater Stephen Bradbury?
No, but I've heard of.
It's a very really quick anecdote.
Okay,
he was coming fourth in the Olympics in skating, and everyone else fell over and he won. And he only got to the Olympics because the same thing happened in his trials. He's the world's luckiest man because everyone else failed ahead of him, and that's how he succeeded. So congratulations on your win, Stephen.
All right, so we need to resolve the end of game stuff. I've recorded the results. So everybody hold on, Steejo won.
Yeah.
Correct?
Yes.
All right, so at the end of the game, basically what happens is everyone turns over any faction cards you've got.
So basically, Steejo gets to choose to do a bunch of stuff. One of those options is name a continent, which gives him an exclusive +1 bonus when he controls the continent. He can found a major city, which counts as 2 regions. So instead of getting 3 troops, he would get 4, 5, 6, so on. Also, cancel a scar. You could do that if you really wanted to. You can change a continent bonus to +1 or -1, but that can only be done once on each continent. Or you could place a fortification mark on a city, which doesn't really matter, or you could destroy a territory card, which you're not going to do anyway, because none of the territory cards are worth anything at the moment.
I think
so what
he's
do you
already
do?
Chosen. You can see he's already doing it.
Stijopia.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
So he's renamed the country.
I feel deja vu.
I know, right?
Yeah.
First All turn. Right.
So
I think I've been it before.
I also have to trade in my starship to get that win, but I do get a missile.
You get a missile. Ooh. And a missile, in case anybody is wondering, allows you to automatically set 1 dice to 6 once. Well, 1 time for each missile, technically.
And you can play a missile on any combat, whether it's your turn, somebody else's turn, whether you're attacked or defended, whether you're not involved in the combat at all, you can always play. You can always play
Stop. One of those scars is unused. This one has been used already. So we keep this in the pile, just face down. And then this is put
in
the
discard
pile.
Yeah.
Back in the pile.
If that makes
sense. Do they get discarded or deleted?
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure they get deleted.
Yeah.
Just delete them.
I'm just going to delete them.
They're supposed to be ripped in half.
The people who survived should now do their thing.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so if you held on but didn't win the game, you get to do a couple of things as well. You can either name and found a minor city, which adds +1 population to that territory. You can upgrade a card with +1 resources. It has to be a territory you controlled at the end of the game. So we get to do one of those two things if we hold on. Starting with the person clockwise to the winner, I think.
Conveniently. Wow, yeah.
Conveniently, oh, so
that's about anti-clockwise? Let Potato do something first.
I don't think it really matters on the way in which we do it. At least not at the moment, anyway.
So I can either add plus one resources to a card or found a minor city. I'm going to found a minor city.
Really? Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
And I'm going to found a minor city in India.
Ooh. Now, there is a limited number of minor cities. There is only 9, I think. So
I was thinking about having one in Yakutsk and just calling it, like, it's fucking cold up here. That would be the name of the city.
All right, so I'm going to lock that in place, zoom right in, and name it.
Oh, you can't write on it. You need to, like, use the text.
Use the text tool, yeah.
Wow, that's really thick.
Yeah,
that's big. Said.
That's what she said. No, okay.
How do you? Can you make it thinner?
Just
that's
use
what
text.
She did.
Yeah, I don't think I can make it thinner.
Use the text tool. Just use the text tool.
Where's the text tool?
It's the T.
All right, so Lolash is doing that. Lolash is doing that. NG, what do you want to do?
Yeah. I think I might find a minor city as well.
All right.
But lots of ego boosting going on. I'm trying to think, should I put one in North America or should I put one in the North? I think we'll put one in America.
Yeah.
You can't put a minor city in India.
Well, I wasn't there. Right, never mind. I have to pick somewhere where I was. That's my bad.
Three options there, buddy.
Yeah, I didn't have a lot of options. Okay. Then I'll put it in Central Africa.
It's a good chip. Good chip.
Yeah, get your Lashville out of my India, bitch.
Why is it floating?
Oh my god, it's doing that thing again.
The gravity. It's the.
There you go.
Is that locked in midair?
No, it's like if you flip it when it does the floating thing, it kind of like goes skew with.
Just can put it back you, in the like, bag just, and get another one.
I was going to say, just copy it. Like, save it to your chest and then.
What to call this city?
All right. Rhapsody, what do you want to do?
I'm going to be founding a minor city. This is also the final minor city token. Do I have to duplicate this a bunch of times? Or
no, it's not. There's six more in the bag. Six more in the bag.
Good. Right. This is going to go in Peru.
So it's worth noting that minor cities make it less worthwhile taking a continent. At least at the start of the game, it's much, much, much worse to take a continent with minor cities on.
Well, I wouldn't say worse.
Wait, what?
But a minor city
costs
you.
It's really difficult. Yeah, it's difficult to take a minor city. So at the start of the game, it's a much, much heavier investment of troopage in order to take it.
But it does give you an extra territory.
Yeah, it gives you an extra territory, though. That's the trade-off.
I'm still going to make this bad decision.
That's not necessarily a bad decision. It just makes it easier for you to get your bonuses. That's Paradox's dog's back. Welcome back, Paradox's dog.
Fuck.
His name's Butter.
You got a dog called Butter?
Yep.
Or have you got another dog called Nut Squash?
Nah.
You should. It's funny because his name is... Oh.
I think I'm going to have to place the name off to one side.
Did you see the new Boaty McBoatface that's circulating?
I don't keep up with the memes, did you? I'm afraid.
Well, it's just today. It was on...
It's fucking meme lord trying to convince you he doesn't keep up with the memes.
Fucking meme lord.
How did you get your writing to stay in the box? Mine refuses to.
By just being better.
Lolash, what you need to do is you need to like zoom in, make sure that you are exactly like above it, right? And then click on, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah,
that's
pretty much perfect. Yeah. It's
really
awkward.
Why is there a city in Alberta?
Fuck, I can't find it in Alberta. Fuck, what an idiot.
Yeah. I did a Lawash. You thought you were green, so...
You did, I
thought I was green, yeah.
Right, have we got anything else that we need to do so we can just wrap up this episode so people don't need to watch you people fail constantly?
Can someone type in the name of my city? I can't type it in for some reason.
Oh my god.
I'm frozen again. I'm frozen again. Are you kidding me?
On that note, Steejo, do you want to take us out and we'll get the game board sorted out and we'll tell you what happened at the beginning of this episode?
Thanks a lot for watching, guys. As always, I've been the winner. You've been awesome, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
See ya. Bye.